Hello creators, my name is Anne and welcome to the rendering tutorial. When your model is finished, it's time to render it to get photorealistic images. Go to menu, render and select render. In this window you can preview your image with interactive rendering. Click here to start it or use this button. Once you have a preview, you can start preparing your scene for rendering. So first thing first, make sure that you are in the thick texture surface mode. I don't, so my fabrics look thin. Switch to it in the top left panel, this icon. And restart interactive render. Click on a stop button and then on an interactive render again. You will need to restart it from time to time to see changes here. Now thickness is visible. If you don't see the seams at all, turn on show seam lines here. You can also use the preview during modeling to see how your materials and fabrics look. Displacement maps and some material types can only be visible in a render window. For example, these material types with the render only sign. If you want to preview and render fast, you need to have Windows and a good NVIDIA graphics card. Cloth3D uses V-Ray Renderer and NVIDIA's CUDA acceleration technology only. Unfortunately, Mac doesn't support NVIDIA, so the only option left for Mac users is a CPU rendering. I checked the render speed on my CPU and GPU, and it was on average 2.5 faster on GPU, which is huge. So the first step for NVIDIA users is to open render properties and change your render engine to the GPU CUDA. If you're going to use CPU anyway, you can notice that Sims doesn't look realistic. Looks like they have inverted normal maps. I found a way how to fix it. Select all Sims in a 2D window with B, edit sewing tool, and you'll see a 3D scene line section in the property editor. You need to change this normal map. Click on the first button and select the second map. Here is the difference. However, they still look different on a GPU rendering. I would even say that they look better on GPU. The next step is to choose the resolution. Let's open image properties. We will get back to the render properties a little bit later. At the right panel, you can see the image size. You need to define dimensions of the image, width and height. I want to have the final render in high resolution, 2K for example. But I don't need it so high for the preview stage when I check my fabrics, rotate the camera and set up a scene and lighting. So I will set it at 720 by 720 to speed up image updating. Set the image size to the adequate minimum, depending on your computer. Also zoom in the image with this button, fit in view. Now you can start adding custom lighting, adjust camera and background. Lighting, I believe, affects the photorealistic result the most. In the light properties, open it, you can see the dome light settings. It's an environmental light that is not so realistic on its own. You can add additional light sources using these buttons. I've created custom lighting earlier, so now I will open it here with this open button. Here we go. The image looks a bit interesting now. The next tip is related to the camera. You can rotate the camera in 3D window to choose the right shot for you. But if you want to take several shots and don't lose the previous positions, you can save them in the Custom Views tab. Go to Menu, Display, Viewpoint, Custom View. Here it is. I've already saved some views here. To make a new one, choose the position and click on a camera button here. It will be added at the bottom of the list. If you want to render all these views one by one, go to the Image Properties and change Current View to Custom Views here. In the Camera Properties, you can adjust camera position and add physical camera properties to the camera. Then you can change your background in the Image Properties. Here, you can choose any color, image texture or turn on transparency. Also, there is a library of textures or other masks. Click on this button and you'll see them. You can apply these masks on a solid color background to get some interesting effects, for example gradations or vignette. I'll choose this one, it corresponds to the light source's position in my scene. And now we're approaching the most important part of rendering, speed. What if I tell you that this image can be rendered in 30 minutes, 10 minutes or 40 seconds depending on the render properties? The first one is rendered on CPU, the second one on GPU, both with maximum render properties. The third one is rendered on GPU, but with optimized render properties. As you see, the quality is almost the same. I believe you'd like to render in 40 seconds than in 30 minutes, wouldn't you? So let's see how we can optimize it. Open the render properties. Noise threshold significantly impacts render time. It defines how much noise will be on the image. Look, Cloth3D renders the image in steps, gradually adding details and reducing noise, until it reaches the target noise level or runs out of time. For example, if I set the noise level to 100, it will take 30 seconds to render this image. If I set it to 50, it will take 40 seconds. 10 noise will take 1 minute 20 seconds, and 1 noise will take an extremely long time, 9 minutes 14 seconds. Each of these results took less than 20 minutes, so Claw3D renders the image until it reaches the target noise level. If I decrease time to 1 minute and leave 1 noise threshold, Claw3D will stop rendering when it runs out of time and leave more noise on the image. In my case, it roughly matches to 10 noise threshold. The only thing is when you set 1 minute, it will actually take 1 minute and a few seconds, up to 20, for some reason. You can notice that there isn't so much difference between the lowest and the highest noise threshold. I believe it's due to the textures. They create a kind of grainy effect and their noise isn't so visible. Usually I set time and noise to a minimum to render images. But if you render an animation, it's worth picking the shortest render time and setting the noise manually to save every second. If you take a look at this dress, you may notice the noise better. In 100 noise threshold and 10 seconds, we have a very grainy image. 50 noise and 13 seconds looks better, but still grainy. 10 noise and 31 seconds looks good. 1 noise and almost 4 minutes is definitely not a great choice. There is hardly any difference between 10 and 1 noise threshold and such a huge difference in time. So the point is to pick a sufficient noise threshold or set a max time, whatever is easier for you. You will need more time or a lower noise threshold to get a clean image for translucent, transparent materials, fur, and if you increase the resolution. Again, render time also depends on your computer and render engine, so your results may differ from mine. Let's move on with the other settings. Check CPU supporting to use CPU along with the GPU. It will slightly speed up rendering. Check low GPU priority if you want to use your graphics card for multiple purposes at the same time, but it will increase the render time. Scene puckering intensity means how noticeable your scenes will be, so it basically controls the normal map intensity for scenes. It doesn't affect the render time. The quality of light and materials also affect the render time, but unlike the noise, it's not necessary to make them very high quality. The difference between low and very high is too little in most cases. Claw3D manual says that we need to increase the quality if we render white fur. I agree, there is a difference. To express light reflections more realistically, when textures are added to the studio environment, such as the wall and floor. I don't quite understand what it means, but I added a mirror to the scene and the reflections looks better on a very high material and very high light quality. Maybe there are some other cases when we need to make it higher, but in most cases, as well as for my image, low quality is great. To sum up, do not increase render time when it's useless. When you are ready to render, get back to the image properties and increase the resolution. I will make it 2K. Choose the file path here. You can name it or use the project name. Select the image format and press the render button. And that's it, here is the final render. Thank you for likes and comments that you leave. I really appreciate it. See you in the next videos. Bye!